This video will talk about solving systems of equations applications. Simple interest. So it's the amount invested multiplied by the interest rate. This is simple interest, as simple as it gets. And remember, your rate's going to be as a decimal. So for example, we have $1,000 invested at 6.5%. It would be $1,000. And if we take the 6.5%, remember you move the decimal two places, so it'd be 0.065. And A would be when I multiply 65. So the amount of interest earned on $1,000 at 6.5% for 1 year is going to be 65. There should probably be a T in here for time, how long it's going to be, but we're just going to use 1 year. So how much is being invested in this problem? Well, let's see. Ian is retiring and has $225,000 to invest in two accounts. Okay, so he's investing $225,000. Ian would like to earn $7,900, and he's going to do that an account paying 3% and one in doing 4%, and those are simple interest. So how much is he investing? Well, he's investing the $225,000. Assign a variable, so the amounts invested in each. We're going to say that he has X at 3% and we're going to say that he has Y at 4%. Using the two variables, it represents the total amount invested. Remember, X is an amount and Y is an amount. So this is really just going to be X plus Y is equal to the $225,000. So let's go on. How much did he need to earn? If you go back and look at the problem, it said that he had $7,900 that he wanted to earn. So how would you represent the amount of interest Ian makes? On the first variable's invested amount, he had X dollars at 3%, we can call that 0.03x. And for the second amount, he had Y dollars that he was investing at 4%, so we're going to call that one 0.04y. So to write the equation using the two amounts that he earns for each, we're going to have 0.03x plus 0.04y. This is an interest, this is an interest, 7,900 is an interest. So interest is equal to interest plus interest. All right, so we want to solve the system. And here's our two equations that we found. Remember, X is the amount at 3%, and Y is the amount at 4%. When you look at the system, this one looks like it would be very nice to use substitution, either solving for X or solving for Y. I'm just going to solve for X. I'm going to say X is equal to 225,000 minus the Y. And then I'm going to substitute that in for the X in the bottom equation. So I have 7,900 is equal to 0.03 times my X, which is 225,000 minus Y, and then plus the 0.04Y. 7,900 then is equal to, when I distribute here, I get 6,750. When I distribute here, I get minus 0.03y and then plus 0.04y. 7,900 is equal to the 6,750 plus 0.01y when I combine my like terms. Subtracting the 6,750, I'm going to have 1,150 is equal to 0.01y. Y is going to be equal to $115,000. That's the Y. We have to find the X. But if I take this Y value and plug it in here for this Y, then I'm going to be able to find X. X is equal to 225,000 minus my 115,000. So X is equal to $110,000 at 3%, and the 115,000 is at 4%.